Hi, Brian. Thank you so much for joining me today on this meeting. We have
Hi,
this
Amy.
project that's coming up that is basically moving our workloads, our SaaS workloads, to the cloud and a lot of our processing into SaaS Viya. And I've been doing a ton of research. I've gone to this cool conference. I've learned a bunch of stuff. But I mean, you're our SaaS administrator. I just want to make sure that I'm running things by you to see if I've got things right.
Yeah, there's still a lot to decide for this project, but it will be good to see if we're on the same page so far.
Thanks. So basically, what I'm learning is things are going to be done in phases. So it sounds like what comes first is kind of code-based things, kind of code-based assets. And what I'm starting to think of is, remember, way back in the day, we had a project where we worked together to move a lot of the SaaS workload from our desktops, our PCs, up to a SaaS server. And I remember from that project that my code pretty much could be moved as is, but I needed to do a little bit of tweaking to make sure that my librefs and my file refs, kind of basically any sort of paths, were pointing to the new location of the data that was on the server.
Yeah, that's actually a good analogy. We're still making decisions on where our data will land, but my bet is that it will be a combination. In some cases, we will be able to move our folder structures as is to the cloud, which means your hard-coded path names will still work if we can keep the same naming convention. In other cases, we may decide to move from the on-premises databases we've been using to a cloud-native data store, so you would need to update things like your lib names to use those new engines. And finally, there's a decision to make on what workloads make sense to move to CAS, which would require updates to your code to take advantage of that multi-threaded processing.
Ugh, that sounds like a lot of work.
Well, we can start simple and work up to the more complex. The good news is there's a set of content assessment tools that we can use to get a better idea of what we have and what our options are. For example, there's a code check tool that identifies SAS code that could be run in CAS versus code that cannot. But let's start with the simple case. I have a Viya environment running in the cloud, and I've mounted a file system like the one you're used to seeing.
Okay, I know what you're talking about. I've been playing around in SAS Studio and I think I've seen what you're talking about. Can I share my screen with you?
Yes.
So in this case, what I'm looking at is the file system, and I can see here there's the data that I expected. It's in the same kind of folder structure that I'm used to. And so what I've learned is in
Mount it.
SAS Studio, I can do this create library just kind of straight on the fly here. And now I'm pointing to that data. So let's bring up just one of my basic programs. And this particular code is showing it's a query that joins a couple of tables. And then it also does a quick plot just to show some different severity reactions for the different treatment groups. And so essentially what's going on here is running the code kind of the way it is, but since the libref points to the new location, yeah, pretty cool.
Yeah,
All right, so I can
works.
see how I can, yeah, which is kind of exciting. So I can see I can move code.
Yeah.
So let me bring up something else though. I've got a bunch of content in SAS Enterprise Guide, and this is actually pretty much the same thing I just showed you, but in EG project form. And so essentially what this one is making use of some of the point and click tools in Enterprise Guide to join two tables and then again to create a bar chart. So my question to you is it going to be as easy to move something like Enterprise Guide content into the cloud and you run it on Viya?
Yeah, you actually gave me several sample EG projects when we talked earlier, and I've been playing around with those to see how they could migrate to SAS Studio on Viya. And I'd like to take over the screen to show you.
Go for it. That'd be awesome.
All right. Now we use SAS Environment Manager to migrate our EG projects. SAS Environment Manager is our web application for managing the SAS Viya environment. I'm going to select the import icon. I'm going to navigate to your EGP file. I'm going to select mapping. Now, this is where we need to tell SAS where to store the newly migrated SAS Studio Flow. So I'll select the target location and I'll put it in a public place so you can see it. I'll select import. And as it's importing, you'll see a message that's saying import job in progress. And down here, you'll see import details. And in this case, the resource was successfully promoted. So now you can see it.
So can I actually give it a try myself?
Sure, please do.
All right, so let me take over the screen again. All right, so I'm back in Studio. Here's where we were before, and you're saying you put it in a public location. So let me pop open public. Ha, look at that. All right, so that's a SAS Studio Flow. Ah, proof though is in what does it look like? So if I open this up in Studio, essentially what we're hoping to see is the...
We're hoping to see something similar to what you saw on EG.
There we go. All right, so there's the flow that I see. So just to remind us, if I go back and look at EG, it's pretty darn good. So basically, I can see the query got set up. Now, here's what I learned when I was doing my research, though. So at this phase of the migration and what's available, what's going to happen is this query is basically got dumped into a code node. And so it's the same code that was generated through the EG query builder, basically code, right? And so what I'm expecting is that as we go through the phases really of migration, SAS Studio has a query builder itself that's a point and click tool. And so what we're expecting is that this will then become a SAS Studio query so that I'd have all the point and click functionality. So my understanding, And so basically my understanding is that right here at the front, everything gets converted to code, but the goal is to convert as much as possible into kind of like to like SAS Studio assets, really. So then let me ask you a question. As we go through this process, are you able to see like a report or something when you're doing the import that shows like what gets converted or what might have some issues?
Actually, yes. We have a migration summary report, and this report will help you view the results of your migrated EG projects. If I can take over the screen, I can show you that report.
Oh, awesome.
Now, our first tab here is an overview. You can see that I've imported 32 EG projects. I can double click here. And this is a quick summary of EG projects that were imported. You can see which of those projects need attention and which of those projects were not migrated. This first graph tells you who actually imported the projects. The second graph is actually what date the projects were migrated on. At the bottom of the tab, we have some statistics to show how many steps have been migrated. We can see that 649 were successful, 23 needed attention, and 262 were not migrated. Now you may want to know why. I can select this tab, Step Details. Now this tab gives me some more details about each project that has been migrated, which project has issues and which do not. I may want to see which projects need attention.
You're right.
Yep. And which projects that have steps that are not migrated. This next tab is a summary of all the step types that have been migrated. We can see detail about each node that was migrated into SAS Studio.
Wow, that's hugely
and this
helpful.
This last tab is a migration timeline. you can see the most recent or historic data on your migrated EG projects. So yes, Amy, there is a report that gives you quite a bit of information about all your EG migrated projects.
All right, so then here's something else that I learned at that conference was that this same process works for all sorts of other assets as well. So for example, we've got a couple of departments who use SAS stored processes, really elaborate ones, and basically they are going to need to move their stuff up. And my understanding is those become SAS via jobs, and the prompts as much as possible are converted over into prompts that'll work. And so those also would come through. They'd be reported really on this same report, and I'd be able to bring that up in studio, do some editing, or you could bring do some management in SAS Environment Manager, schedule them or whatever. And along the same lines, I know the data management department makes heavy use of Data Integration Studio, which also has jobs that have flows on them. And again, same idea here is they get transferred over as studio flows, and same kind of phased approach where they start off being moved as code, basically, so the transforms become code nodes, but ultimately we're trying to hopefully have more like to like. So have you played around any with this, the DI Studio jobs?
Yes, I have. And it's actually a very similar process to the EG migration process. And you are right, the SAS, the DI Studio nodes will be migrated to SAS program nodes in SAS Studio. So okay. I'm going to select source here. I'm still sharing my screen. I'm going to navigate to a DI Studio job. In this case, I've got joinjob.spk. Here, I want to unselect the select all and only select my join job. I'll select mapping as I did before, and we'll keep it in the public location so you can see it. And we'll select import. Same as EG, you'll see the import job is in progress, and down below you'll see the import details. And in this case, we see the resource was successfully promoted. So you should be able to see this job as well.
All right, I know what to do now. So I'm going to take my over the screen again, and let me see if I can bring up SAS Studio. So what you're saying is if we look in public and I refresh this, look at that. So there's the job All you right. just imported from DI.
That's
Let's
it.
Bring that up. Huh, there we go. So I know DI Studio jobs have pre and post code that shows there. And again, there's a join and same as before. So the join that comes over in this first phase, at least, comes over as a code node. And the goal is eventually we'll have join transforms and all the other supported kind of transforms as much as possible on the SAS Studio side so that we can put these into like to like kind of nodes. Yeah. Yep. All right. Okay. So then my other question for you is, this is fun to play with, and I see how we'd use it pretty heavily when we're doing our testing, but we have a ton of these things. Are you going to have to go through a UI to do all of this when we're ready to do some mass movement, or is there some other way?
We actually have a faster way. We have a command line interface, or CLI. Using the CLI, you can interact directly with SAS via programmatically without using the GUI.
Okay.
And I'll take over my screen and show you how to import a whole folder of projects. So in this case, I've already run a few commands to point to my SAS via environment. And now I'll run the command that actually imports all of the EG projects in this folder here. This is import egprojects.exe, and I point to a source location of /my EG projects. I can hit enter. One more time.
You didn't hit it hard enough.
Yep. So in this actual folder, I have three EG projects, and as the CLI is running, it'll spit out messages and tell you if the EG project was actually uploaded and imported successfully. In this case, we've already done the first one. We're working on the second one now. And that one's done, and we're on the third one. At the end here, very quickly, we should see that we had 3 Enterprise Guide projects imported successfully. None failed to import and none were skipped. So yes, we do have a faster way.
Wow. I'm starting to feel a lot better about this whole process.
Yeah. So to summarize, what did we do here today? We migrated an Enterprise Guide project using the GUI in SAS Environment Manager. We used CLI to import an entire folder of EG projects, and we showed a migration report to help you look at the results of migrating your SAS 9 EG projects to SAS Studio Flows in SAS VIA.
All right. So it feels like on my end, we just need to kind of keep the phased approach in mind and kind of concentrate on the code-based stuff first. And as the import becomes more and more robust, then we can bring more and more folks on board and really, I guess, just start working on how we want to optimize and make the code run even faster. So yeah, like I said, right. I feel a lot better about this. How about you?
Feeling good.
All right. Well, this is the beginning of a lot of conversations. So I look forward to us really getting this project going. Thank you again for your time, Brian. It's really helpful.
All right. Thank you very much, Amy.